I made a couple of changes, and I think it's time here to pay tribute to Dan Parks. What a great servant he's been to Scottish rugby. I've really enjoyed working with him, the enthusiasm that he's shown as a player, and his ability to win games, I think, were tremendous. And you know, the victories that we had against Ireland away and in Argentina, South Africa back here, you know, were through Dan's expertise.
But it's a chance, of course, to see Greg on from the start with Chris as his halfback partner.
Yes, and Greg's first opportunity, his first start. He's a tremendous competitor, and I think he's looking forward to being challenged by this Welsh defence.
And of course, at the same time, bringing and Duncan Weir onto the bench with the possibility, obviously, for a first cap for him.
Yeah, well, Duncan has done well for Glasgow. He's not had a lot of rugby in his career because he's been a young lad, and delighted with the way he played in the Saxons game last week and the victory that they had. And I think it just gives him confidence of being able to play at this level, and I think that's key for any 10 coming in, is that they've got confidence in their performance.
Always difficult going down to Wales to the Millennium Stadium, but playing late would have been better going with a victory behind you. But I'm sure the players will be looking to make amends in many ways for the various problems we had on Saturday.
The issues that we've had at the weekend were not being able to convert chances, and that's the key element for us. You know, if we create that many chances, I'm sure that we will take them. If we create a couple, I believe that we'll take them this weekend.
I mean, plainly there must be encouragement in that the chances are being made. Obviously it's incredibly frustrating that they're not being turned into appropriate points.
The results hurt, and just with the expectation that's there because the side have been performing well, and it's just that step and being able to take that one step. It will come, it will happen, and what we've got to look at is focusing on it happening this weekend.
You referred there to the Saxons game and the success of the Scotland A side against the Saxons, and one standout performer, Stuart Hogg, makes his way onto the bench. Now, he will provide some versatility, will allow you to perhaps use him in a number of roles depending on how Sunday's match pans out.
Yeah, definitely, and I see predominantly Stuart as a 15. Yeah, I think he's a real quality rugby player. He's got great ball skills and ball awareness and spatial awareness, and I'm looking forward to him getting his first chance.
Jeff Cross obviously coming into the front row. One thing that does obviously do is mean you have the continuity of three Edinburgh-based players starting against Wales on Sunday.
It's important that they're able to use that as an advantage, and the way we do that is by winning that hit and working hard in the scrum.
Well, Stuart, many congratulations on getting onto the bench. Plainly, that fantastic try on Friday night helped to some extent. And hopefully, I'm sure you get on down in Wales.
Yeah, obviously, thanks very much. It would be great to get on. I'm just really chuffed to be part of the squad. But yeah, I'm hoping I get some game time and be able to win my first cap.
Been kind of quick, really, this. It's not that long ago, possibly, this wasn't really in your thinking at all, that you'd be in the Scotland squad for a match down in Wales.
No, obviously, as a kid, you dream of playing for Scotland, and now that I've got the opportunity, if I get on, I'm going to grab it with both hands and hopefully do what I've been doing and really enjoy it.
Do you think you can bring the kind of cavalier sort of attitude in many ways that so many of the players had in the A team on Friday night? It was such an exciting free-running way, which is the kind of way that we're looking for Scotland to play.
Yeah, definitely. You know, the A boys really dug deep and worked hard for each other, and it was a great atmosphere we had in the camp leading up to that game. So yeah, hope that it's been much the same this week with the Scotland boys in the national squad, so hopefully come Sunday, things will come good for us.
Well, when did you hear you were in the squad in the 22?
Yesterday morning when the team was announced, kind of started getting really quite nervous, but I was more excited, and as I say, really looking forward to that.
How big a challenge is it for Scotland?
Oh, it's massive. You know, they've got some key ball players and really strong runners in their team, but we can see where they're weak and where they're strong, so we're gonna target these areas and as I say, hopefully come good in on the day with our performance.
Andy's blooding some youngsters and young talent in terms of Greg Laidlaw, Duncan, yourself and others. What do you feel like you can collectively bring to the team?
Greg's a great ball player and he's an even better guy. So he fully deserves his shot at 10, and Dunkey's been playing well all season, so again, he fully deserves to be on the bench. So hopefully these boys can perform. No doubt Greg will perform, and Dunkey myself, if he gets some game time, hopefully we can perform as well.
It does, I guess, illustrate the importance of an A international, in as much as it's a shop window, an opportunity to show the Scotland selectors what you can do at international level.
Yeah, definitely. You know, Friday night was fantastic for us to get a good result and even better performance from all the team. Even better to score a try, which was fantastic. And as I say, Dunkey played well, the whole team played well, so fingers crossed this week we can do the same.
And if Sunday is indeed the day that you make that first step onto the field as a full international player, you'll join quite an elite band of international players that have won the first cap as a teenager.
Yeah, definitely. No, if I get on, it'll be a dream come true. So, as I say, fingers crossed it happens.
Proud and honoured to have the chance to get my first cap, especially at the Millennium Stadium. The guys have been saying all week that it's a fantastic arena, and with that roof shut on Sunday, it'll be a great atmosphere, and my family and a few of my friends are coming down, so it'll be a great feeling to get on and have a wee trot about.
What's been the mood in the camp? Because I think the frustration's doubled by the fact that Scotland had the majority of that game against England, and yet it just wasn't finished off on the day. So what have the players been saying to each other? What kind of mood are you going into this game?
Positive. Like, as you said, the chances are there. They just need to be the kind of final passes, and the whole saga that Scotland don't score tries and all that will be out the window, and we'll be going in and hopefully really punishing teams, and like the A's done on Friday night against the Saxons. We went out and scored four tries and kept the Saxons to zero, so it was a great performance there, and I'm hoping that the full team can do the same this weekend.
You backed yourself for your try. You're not going to be daunted by the fact that you're at Millennium Stadium. It's a bigger crowd. You'll still back yourself?
If the same chance comes about, then I'll hopefully get my legs going and bundle over and get a few fens off and hopefully get my feet through and get through the space, and if I score a try in your first cap, then that would be something to top it off even more special.
What are your thoughts about Dan retiring from international rugby?
Yeah, I had no clue. I look at Dan and as a big brother figure to me. He's helped me a lot, and he's always given me great advice, and just the kind of the vibe that you get off the guy is fantastic around the training pitch. So no, obviously I'll miss the fact, and it was a mixed emotions when I got the call, because I knew that he was going to be retiring, but I knew that it was fantastic for me to get my chance in the full team. So yeah, it was mixed emotions, but as I said, he's had a fantastic run, and hopefully if I can mirror that to any shape or size, then it would be brilliant for me.